Earl, there he is.
Good morning.
Thank you so
Well,
much.
hello from the Shenandoah Valley of Virginia.
Oh yes, all the way across the country there.
Earl, during these times of isolation, it's really hard for people to sort of, I guess, fathom what is going on. I know your book really talks about getting people through difficult times, especially with your experience working with the American Red Cross, with people who have gone through a lot of disasters. How can you take what you've learned there and written about and apply it to the situation that people around the world are dealing with right now?
Well, this is not a normal time. This is really a hard time, and that's the first thing you have to remember. And you really have to focus on taking care of yourself. I love the segment before where the mother and daughter were exercising, because you're not only taking care of yourself, you're taking care of others. And then you have to figure out what you really need, and just also, be nice to yourself and be kind to one another. It's okay to have ice cream for breakfast.
Hey.
Yeah, you're really talking about the self-care, and a lot of people's, emotional, I guess, mindset or emotional aspect is really being impacted by this. Why is it so important to have a vital care when it comes to your emotional health as well through these times?
Well, we're emotional, we're feeling beings, and you guys have been through so much with the California wildfires and everything, and you're traumatized, and this is yet another trauma that wasn't anticipated, has mass fatalities, and it's really a scary time. So you have to listen for those emotions and not try to distract yourself, but feel the feelings and be of support to one another. Be a good neighbor.
Right. Also, I think people at this time, we hear such the news and it gets us down. What about the hope?
Well, you have to find out what, when you're talking with people or even yourself, find, sources of hope. What gives you hope? Is it your family? Is it your faith? Is it your work? I mean, some people feel very hopeful when they're out there in the garden with the garden lady pulling weeds, because planting things are a symbol that, you are looking forward to the future when those plants bloom and flourish. And don't be afraid, just be informed. We have people who are trained, medical professionals, all sorts of people who are trained to help, and you don't have to do this by yourself. So my advice to everyone is don't be afraid, but just be informed.
Yes, definitely. I think sometimes also there might be an overload of information too that can get to people. Thank you so much for your time.
Yes, again, Earl Johnson, author of Finding Comfort During Hard Times. If you want more information, we'll have it on our website, his website as well, earljohnson.org. We really appreciate you sharing your valuable tips with all of us here in California, Earl. Thank you.
My pleasure.
All right, take care.